homeless and we need some things. We need, you know, we suffer from for our own decisions. That's most of the reason why most of us are here. And I'm one, because I made a lot of bad decisions in my life, and I'm paying for them now. So it's a blessing that people still have grace and mercy on people like the homeless. And thank you, Salvation.
It's 20 degrees and sleeting rain. Piercing winds cut through the empty streets of Jackson.
All right, God bless you, brother.
God bless you, too, brother.
All right.
The Salvation Army ventures out on nights like this to minister the love of Christ by giving food, blankets, and clothing to the homeless.
A lot of despair down here, but we're bringing hope tonight. Christ is the answer.
Giving hope to the hopeless. That's what Captain Ken Chapman and the Jackson Corps do 365 days a year. Wherever there is a need, the Salvation Army responds quickly. When a tornado hit Yazoo City, the Salvation Army was first on the scene with food, water, and hope for storm victims.
If it had not been for the Salvation Army, I don't see how we could have made it through, because they stepped up to the plate and brought everybody together.
5 months after the tornado, more than $130,000 worth of furniture was delivered to those who were getting back on their feet.
Well, Wednesday night is when we have our character building program, and we have probably 150 kids here that come and eat supper. They have character building classes like Girl Guards and Sunbeams and music classes and piano and singing company and Rangers and Scouts. This is part of the beginning band class, and they're learning how to play instruments for the very first time.
Blow stronger. Okay, you know what? That's a high C.
Because they help you. And they tell you good stuff about God. And if you come to church, you will always start to come again.
I'll put you one of those in there as well.
More than 40,000 people receive food from the Jackson Corps each year. Thousands receive assistance for rent and utility bills. High school dropouts are getting their GEDs through the Jackson Corps.
I love to see people reach their potential. I think it's really important for everybody to contribute to society and to use the mind that the Lord gave them.
At the Center of Hope, adults like Julius find new life. At the age of 14, he was already addicted to alcohol. He was estranged from his father, and his home life was in shambles. Years of depression led to one night when he was ready to give it all up and commit suicide.
Trying to find some kind of meaning, you know, and, you know, just trying to make myself feel worthy. When I made up my mind, hit the tree, you know, I was like, no, I don't want to do this. It just hit me then. But then it was just this calming voice. It just said, you know, don't worry. Everything's going to be all right.
With help from a friend, he made his way to the Center of Hope. Now he is out on his own, employed at the Salvation Army, and living a life he never dreamed possible. The Salvation Army of Jackson is transforming our community one life at a time.
Thank you, Salvation Army!